हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू योर ऑनलाइन लेक्चर. लास्ट वीक वी डिडंट मेट, राइट? सो इफ़ यू रिमेंबर, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड विथ 3 यूनिट्स. सो डू यू रिमेंबर व्हाट आर दिस 3 यूनिट्स, एनीवन? सो लेट मी रिमाइंड यू अबाउट द यूनिट नेम्स एटलीस्ट. सो योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज ऑफ एनवायरमेंट, second energy resources, and the third one is ecosystem and biodiversity. So before moving to the next chapter, the way I usually do, first we will see a revision of chapter number 3 at a one glance. So in chapter number 3 we have studied with ecosystem and biodiversity. So let's revise. What is ecosystem? You can see a figure here, image here. Ecosystem consisting of living things, non-living things, soil, water, air, sun. So this entire environment is called as ecosystem. So an ecosystem is a community of interacting organisms and their environment. Ecosystem often contain many living things and can be as small as your backyard or as large as the ocean. See, a system or a part or an area which contains, whether it can be a living thing, non-living thing, so that part can be an ecosystem. Now, what are the characteristics of ecosystem? The first line is very important. Ecosystem can be of any size. And the sun is a primary source of energy. And during flow of energy, all components get role to play as primary, secondary, and tertiary producers or consumers. So these are the basic characteristics of ecosystem. Then we have seen a classification of ecosystem. So what is the classification? Actually, there are two types of classification, natural and artificial. We are not going to focus on artificial. Let's see what are the natural ecosystems. So you can see one flowchart here, natural ecosystem. It has two parts, aquatic and terrestrial. So terrestrial means they include grassland, desert, forest, mountains, etc. And where aquatic contains marine and fresh water. Now you can see here, or you can tell me what are the sources of fresh water? Lake, pond, river, these are the sources of fresh water. Then we have seen food chain. What is food chain? We know about food chain. In a certain food chain, each organism gets energy from the one at the level below. In a food chain, there is a reliable energy transfer through each stage. All the energy at one stage of the chain is not absorbed by the organism at the next stage. And who has introduced this food chain? African Arab scientist and philosopher Al-Zahiz in the 9th century. Then, we have studied about food web. What is the meaning of web? Web means network. A food web can be defined as a network of interconnected food chains so as to form a number of feeding relationships amongst different organisms of biotic community. So food chain comprises of n number of food web comprises of n number of food chains in a single ecosystem. Then we have learnt about ecological pyramid. Pyramid means what? It's a graphical representation of anything. Here the term is ecological pyramid means it's a graphical representation to show the number of organisms, biomass and productivity at each trophic level. It is also known as energy pyramid. So this pyramid always starts with producer and then it goes with consumer. Now here I have listed a types of ecological pyramid. Pyramid of biomass, productivity and pyramid of numbers. You have to recall all these concepts. Then biodiversity. After ecosystem, we have started with biodiversity. What is biodiversity? Biodiversity is a shortened form of biological diversity. It refers to the existence of number of different species of plants and animals in an environment. We know environment. Environment consists of biotic and abiotic components. So living things can be animals, plants, but we can see n number of plants and animals, different variety of plants and animals. So they are only called as biodiversity. Here again I have listed of different types of biodiversity: genetic biodiversity, species biodiversity, ecological biodiversity. From the name you can guess its meaning. Genetic, genes, where genes are derived. Species, some particular living thing belong to particular species. Then ecological biodiversity. After that, we have seen biogeographical regions in India. Here you can see one image, so total 3, 6, 9, 10. So India is divided into 10 recognizable biogeographic zones. So here they have listed Andaman Nicobar Coastal Region, Northeast Region, Gangetic Plains, Deccan Plateau, Western Ghats, Semi-Arid Region, Indian Desert Zone, Himalaya Zone, Trans-Himalayan Region. So these are the 10 different biogeographical regions of India. Then, these 10 different areas in previous slide, we have studied thoroughly, okay? Now, after that, we have learned threats to biodiversity by IUCN. So what are the basic threats to any biodiversity? It's habitat destruction. Deforestation, we can call it as threats posed by exotic species, poaching of wildlife, genetic pollution, and climatic change. These are the basic threats to biodiversity. Now, what is exotic species? Exotic species means species which are belongs to one particular area, but we introduce them into a totally different area. For, let's take an example of kangaroos. Kangaroos means kangaroo. Kangaroo is not the correct pronunciation. Kangaroos. So kangaroos, actually they belongs to Australia, but suppose we love them and we brought them into India, then they are called as exotic species. So they might create problem in India. So that is called as threats posed by exotic species. Then poaching of wildlife, killing, hunting and killing wild animals, genetic pollution, and then the last one is climatic change. Now, hotspots of biodiversity. Here three important and representative hotspots of India are given: Western Ghat, Eastern Himalaya and Indo-Burma region. These are the three hotspots of biodiversity in India. Then, so this is all about your revision. Thank you.